land discovered thousands of years before Columbus. This is the first time people have come face to face with monstrous animals that roam the continent of North America. In 1968, construction workers made a chilling discovery. They uncovered the remains of a human skeleton, evidence of the first people to set foot in the Americas.
God, look at this.
With the bones were over 100 razor-sharp spear points made from semi-precious stones. They were the sharpest blades humans had ever created. Forensic archaeologists discovered that the skeleton was a young child's. Both the body and the spear points had been covered in red ochre, an earthly symbol used in rituals of life and death. Why was this child buried with all these weapons? Unraveling this mystery offers tantalizing clues to the secrets of a lost world. A world where people really did meet monsters. Radiocarbon dating revealed that the child lived 13,000 years ago, the time this story takes place. We are in the dying years of the last ice age, just moments past in the vastness of geological time, but a world quite different from the one we live in today. Yet the people living here, like Shiyu and her only child, Sun Ka, are just like you and me. They are intelligent, highly skilled, and share a complex language and emotions. These people are living at a time when the world around them is changing, and they face an uncertain future.
Wee.
Several years have passed, and Sun Kar has died. Her ochre-covered body is to be buried in a clifftop in Montana. Chiyo has lost her only child. The land is warming. It should be a paradise. But it isn't. Why? Because once there were great creatures, and now there are only bones. These are the ancestors of today's Native Americans. Their story is an epic tale, pieced together bit by bit from the fragments of evidence they left behind. So what do we know of these people? To find out, we must look further back into their history, long before Shiyo's child was born. During the last ice age, much of the sea was frozen in mountains of ice. This made sea levels 70 meters lower than today. A vast land bridge of ice joined the Asian continent to the far north of America. Many scientists believe it was across this desolate land 14,000 years ago that the first people found their way into the New World. They were pioneers, the descendants of Siberian hunters who'd honed their survival skills in the brutality of Asia's frozen wastes. In discovering the Americas, these people laid claim to a quarter of the world's landmass. In that moment, when the first human footprints appeared, the course of history was changed forever. Successive waves of people made this epic journey. As each new group came in and spread out to explore their newfound world, nothing could prepare them for what they were about to discover. Shiyo and her brothers are the first people to reach this mountain range. They are discovering a Garden of Eden, an eternal frontier teeming with animals.
Looks
they discover is home to more species of elephant and big cat than anywhere else on Earth. The woolly mammoth. Its dense coat and thick layer of insulating fat make it superbly efficient at staying warm in the merciless cold. In its back is a fat-filled hump, a vital energy resource for times when food is scarce. Its great tusks are used to dig for vegetation under deep snow, as well as combat when rival males compete for a mate. Like the woolly mammoth, the muskox is a tenacious survivor. They are tough-horned, aggressive beasts who defend themselves by gathering in a tight-knit pack. Migrating herds of Saiga antelope graze the plains, a bizarre mix between goat and antelope. Caribou and two species of buffalo gather in huge herds. There are five species of horse. The horse evolved in North America 4 million years ago and subsequently migrated to the rest of the world. This new world is home to the largest cats ever seen. The North American lion is at least a third bigger than the African lion. In competition is the smaller cheetah-like American scimitar cat with serrated knife-like canines adapted for preying on young mastodons and mammoths. Formidable feline predator by far is the saber-tooth. Armed with awesome canines, it waits to ambush its prey. It takes ingenuity to survive in a land blasted by bitter winds. But these are sophisticated people, equipped with technology that enables them to endure the extreme climate. To exist in temperatures as low as minus 60, these people construct cold weather clothing that will never be bettered. Garments are cut in insulating layers from fur and tanned hides, threaded together with waterproof stitching. They are masters of fire and bushcraft. There are killers here. But it's also a land of opportunists. Scavengers like the wolverine make the most of any nutritious scraps left behind. For the new settlers, there are unwelcome surprises in the new world.
50.
Certainly aren't the remains of a wolf kill. Hekar and Setan have never encountered a creature capable of such devastation, an animal of such power that it can strip the flesh and snap the bones of a caribou like this.
Here was it.
They have arrived in a world of super predators. A world of monsters.
Listen!
Caribou made the same journey as people from Asia across the Bering land bridge. Nomadic hunters probably followed the tracks of migrating caribou into the New World. They are highly prized for their meat, insulating hides, and sinew. Caribou are familiar to man, but man is familiar to caribou. The great herds have long been wary of the threat of the human hunter. These hunters use their intimate knowledge of the natural world to their advantage, staying downwind to avoid betraying their presence. The hunters disguise themselves in caribou capes to get close enough to launch an attack. Kill will provide Setan's people with enough food for just one day. Night on the tundra. The temperature plummets. The time to take protection from the merciless cold. The time to stay alert to dangers that prowl under the cover of darkness. Saber-tooth. Larger and more ferocious than any lion. Armed with 7-inch daggers, designed for puncturing flesh and severing arteries. Ambush specialists that disembowel and bleed their victims to death. They're lucky. The saber-tooth has never seen an animal with fire in its hands. But these people will always have to be on their guard. There are other monsters they are yet to meet. The saber-tooth is the least of their worries. Until now, the giant ground sloth has lived in a world without man. On first encounter, it's fearless. No animal of human size has ever posed a threat. Chiyo and her brother can even walk up and touch this giant. The sloth is vulnerable, and man will be quick to exploit its innocent nature. Strangers arrive. Sitan and Shiyo are understandably anxious. They thought they were alone. they share their world with people armed with far more powerful weapons. With the shock of this encounter, their life will never be the same again. Now their future is balanced on a knife edge. Has introduced Setan's people to a technology they've never seen. A spear point of flawless geometry, a lethal weapon that in later years will give the early settlers of North America their name and identity. The Clovis. Contact is vital, allowing the exchange of information and raw materials. It's also an opportunity for courtship. Clovis, New Mexico, is where this kind of spear point was originally unearthed in 1932. And it's from this town that the first Americans derive their name. It was the first of many finds later made throughout the continent. By perfecting the skills to make and use the Clovis point, these people are in possession of a devastatingly powerful and accurate weapon. The Clovis are master craftsmen. They are superbly skilled flint knappers. The semi-precious stones like chert, quartz crystal, jasper, and obsidian needed to make these points are so prized, it's not uncommon for the Clovis to walk 1,500 kilometers in search of new sources. It takes years to master these techniques. Their weapons are exquisite, designed to maximize penetration. Armed with the Clovis point, humans now held the most deadly weapon the world had ever seen. Now they can hunt the very largest of animals. Weighing up to 8 tons, the woolly mammoth is one of the largest animals in North America. These vast creatures provide the Clovis with fat, nutritious marrow, and bone for making tools. Mammoth bones have been found all over America. In Arizona, 8 Clovis spear points were discovered embedded in an adult mammoth skeleton. Each weapon inflicted a mortal wound. Hunters fire spears in deadly quick succession, killing animals in their prime. Here they select the herd leader, the matriarch. The Clovis have developed a hunting strategy that will have dire consequences. Celebration. A time to reenact the hunt and the kill. Spiritual dimension to their culture. It's possible that when the hunter holds a spear, he believes he can harness some greater power. A slain mammoth can provide enough food to satisfy hungry stomachs for weeks. But it's always risky to return to the kill. It's a magnet for the most fearsome predators. Short-faced bear, the largest and most intimidating mammalian predator that has ever hunted on land. It's an astoundingly efficient killer, capable of running at speeds in excess of 60 kilometers per hour. Despite the menace of predators, the Clovis managed to survive and prosper. The population endures periodic losses. In fact, Clovis numbers are rapidly increasing. In virgin lands with plentiful resources, a population of only 200 can increase to 70,000 in just 30 generations, 1,000 years. The time it takes the Clovis to conquer the Americas. Chio doesn't know it, but her only child is soon to die. She's born into a world that is in decline. The climate is rapidly warming, and the Ice Age is coming to a dramatic end. Ice fields are melting, and the American continent is reshaping. It's at this time North American animals like the saber-tooth, mammoth, and the short-faced bear are vanishing. But why? Is it the trauma of this accelerated period of global warming? Probably not. These animals have survived 17 similar climate cycles. So why is this one proving so fatal? Humans are here. The one thing that distinguishes this ice age from all the others that have gone before. The Clovis may have thought they had discovered an eternal frontier with an inexhaustible bounty of animals. Yet, within as little as 1,000 years of human arrival, 30 kinds of animal are becoming extinct. Coincidence? Or were the Clovis responsible? America was once home to five kinds of horse. There were also two types of camel. The Clovis slaughtered horses and camels. The blood of an extinct horse was recently identified on a Clovis spear point. A bone from an extinct camel shows the signs of human butchery. Many scientists are convinced that the Clovis were responsible for killing all the continent's great herbivores. And with the disappearance of most of the large plant eaters like the mammoth, horse, camel, and ground sloth, predators could no longer be sustained. If humans are to blame, they are guilty of causing the greatest mass extinction since the dinosaurs perished 65 million years ago. Shiyo's child is dead. Here on a clifftop in Montana, her people gather to lay her child to rest. They carry hundreds of spear points to place in the child's grave. Why? Is it a time of starvation? Are the Clovis points being laid down as a gesture to appease the gods? Have their deadly weapons become redundant in an empty land? One thing is certain. At the time this child is buried, all the animals the Clovis spear point was designed to slaughter have vanished. Once there were great creatures, and now there are only bones. The loss of the New World's giant animals may have forced the Clovis to reassess their relationship with nature. There is evidence that they changed their ways and became a people living in greater harmony with the natural world. For the next 12,000 years, there were no more extinctions in the Americas. Then, strangers from foreign lands turned up on the horizon. With Columbus in 1492, a new wave of pioneers, Europeans, landed on America's shores. And once again, a new group of humans laid claim to the continent. Later, the conquistadors arrived. And the image of men galloping on horses struck fear into the hearts of the Native Americans. They believed they were seeing monstrous ghosts. Ironically, horses were returning to the land of their evolutionary origin, 12,000 years after their predecessors had perished on the Clovis Spear Point. To the Clovis, the horse had meant only meat. But the European pioneers had learned to exploit the horse for a different use. Humans were now armed with a weapon far more deadly than the Clovis spear point, and history was set to repeat itself. Horse-mounted hunters wielding rapidly repeating rifles had turned into ruthlessly efficient killers. Within 70 years, they slaughtered 60 million buffalo. Buffalo herds of the American prairie once formed the greatest aggregation of mammals ever to populate the earth. And yet one of nature's great marvels was lost. Bison were massacred for their tongues and shot for sport. In 1893, only 500 wild buffalo remained. Native Americans lost their livelihood. Smoking gun is in our hands. Somewhere in our battle for survival, we acquired the power to cause extinction.